Bolton Hoovering Festival bank holiday weekend, and you are doing three things on Saturday the 26th of August. So you've got first demo at 10:30.
Yeah, well, we're doing brunch, so a couple of brunch this year, so people come along and do a bit of demo. And then basically I'll talk nonsense, because it's a weird one. It's the second time I've done Bob. I did the very first one, and so I'm going to do a bit of a history of, really, of how I started and how it all got to where it was. So I'm quite looking forward to it. So rather than just being a straight demo, I'm going to entertain people over their breakfast.
And then you've got one at 10:30, one at 12:30. Now I've noticed that they're both different prices. So what are you cooking for the lunchtime one?
So the lunchtime one, we're doing a white chocolate and raspberry tart, which is delicious. We're doing a beef salad, and we're doing a salmon dish. And just very delicious, lovely, using as much local produce as we possibly can. And you sort of try and show technique, show things that people can do. I always sort of think that when you do a cookery demo, people should go away and think, I could have a go at that. I'm not the biggest fan of kind of doing something that says, look how brilliant I am. You know, I don't want to kind of do a really complicated souffle and go, it's really good that, you know, I'd never do it. For me, I always want to inspire people.
But isn't that the point? Because you're self-taught. So you've never kind of gone through the ranks of being kind of doing anything kind of fancy. It's all about, you are all about being accessible. Do look, I can do it.
Yeah, I think that is undoubtedly my brand, if you like. That, you know, I think that I love food, I love cooking, and if I get more people to stand in the kitchen and cook food from scratch, then that's my job done. Certainly, you know, Sunday brunch, that's undoubtedly my ethos. Every single recipe I do, the time I start writing something, that's a little bit chefy, and so you'll maybe bring it down so it's maybe more accessible, or maybe the ingredients are more accessible. Yeah, I think it's massively important.
So then at 2:30, you've got a beer and pasty tasting with Simon Rimmer.
Yeah, I've created a pulled lamb vindaloo pasty specially for the festival, and we're going to taste, I think it's about 6 pasties, which we're going to match with craft beers. I mean, what's not to like? You know, I'm sort of thinking, when this was sort of put to me, go, how do you fancy in that? You're going, what, this is for real?
Yeah,
I'm
no, you had me
paid.
At 6 pasties. No, yeah. I'm there, sold. Right, so that's £15 head, 6 pasties, 6 beers,
yeah.
Beers, all local beers.
Yeah, well, all craft beers, maybe not local though, because I think when you say local beers, people think all from Bolton.
Right.
Certainly all from the northwest, all, you know, all on the right side of the pound.
So you say, is this the first time you've done Bolton Food and Drink Festival?
Second, I actually did the very first year, but it was nowhere near as big and bold as it is now.
Neither were you.
Well, you're not wrong. And I really enjoyed it. It was a really good festival. And I think what it actually does really well, a lot of food festivals these days, they've kind of lost a little bit of identity, they've lost that regionality, that they tend to be a lot of burgers being sold and people selling olives, and you think, well, if I'm doing a food festival in Ipswich, then there's no olives in Ipswich and I can buy a burger anywhere. Whereas Bolton, it still manages to do that great thing and say, look, this is what we have in our locality, and that makes such a difference.
Yeah, it's true. Okay, so that's 3 things, Saturday the 26th. Of August at the Bolton Food